And so we are very happy to have 5 graduates. This year has been extremely, extremely challenging, as I'm sure y'all know. When we switched over to virtual 15 months ago, we weren't sure exactly what we were going to be doing starting for 2020 to 2021. But we are very happy that we were able to have younger students be able to attend in person, since we know that has been very, very extremely useful to them as learning Chinese education and culture. And we had our older kids successfully be able to do a virtual platform and continue their education and be able to progress in their Chinese language and culture education. So the first thing I need to do is acknowledge the extreme, I can't even say energy and efforts of our principal, Principal Lu, and our treasurer, Monica. Monica? Everybody give him a round of applause, please. They have been so outstanding in not just their efforts to do their own jobs, but also to help us keep moving forward in our school and doing whatever was necessary. I can only tell you about the countless hours Rebecca spent talking to CACC to be able to make events happen, to let us back into the school, to talk about what kind of a reopening protocol we would have, all the hours that Monica spent to make sure that we actually stayed on budget, or we had a budget, or that we were able to meet the expenses of opening during the pandemic. So I really applaud them for their efforts. I also want to thank Louise Flynn. He was the wife of one of our board members who also was exceptional in her energy and support of our efforts to reopen the school in the pandemic. Applause for Louise, please. I could always count on her to be able to fill in to take temperatures, which you saw her do today, fill out health sheets for us. She was an invaluable source of information for me when it came to talk about what we do for the reopening, and she also works in the medical field like I do. So I just think that we have been extremely successful through our team efforts. And of course, I want to thank my fellow board members, Bill Flynn and Cal Nave, for their unconditional support of anything I said. Didn't matter what I asked, didn't matter what I proposed, they said, yes, go ahead and do it. And I so appreciated that. And then when I really needed input, they would provide that, So their wives have trained them well. So I would like to give them an applause. And then the last thing is, of course, the students. I want to thank our students for being so diligent and willing to put the time, effort, and commitment to continuing their education. I have been so proud of not just my own kids, I don't know why I'm crying, but also of all the kids who have shown up, done their work, and who are gonna perform today. You will see that even if they're not perfect, they try, and I think that is the most important thing. So applause for our students. And last but not least, my husband. Apparently, I have to point out my husband, Scott, who has been endless in his support of me and allowing me to continue with all my efforts to make sure the school stays open and successful, and of course, the support of our daughter and our son. Thank you. Before I have to see the stage, I am going to hand out little gifts of appreciation to the important people that I just talked about.
Tons of meeting with the CSCC. She actually helped me a lot. like last August, I don't know how I survived. What's this all? I don't know how many documentation we have to write. So I really appreciate it. And also Sunday, when she's not working, she's here helping to measure teachers, that not just only teachers, all the kids, the temperature. So that's, I just want to say thank you very much. Decided to send his wife over, so okay. So I want to also thank you, Luis. Actually, like constantly her kids, their kids actually is online, but she still show up the Sunday afternoon, help me to measure the temperature, set up students, everything for me, because this is, has been hard year for everyone. So I want to say thank you too. You don't have flower, but I do have a card, is Suji. She is our TA. Actually, one thing is, she is a former graduate from our school 3 years ago or 5 years ago? I don't know, X years, 5 years already. So she actually kind enough to come back to help us to be our TA. So she's not just only our teaching assistant to help our kindergarten, she's also helped me even whatever we have to do, she and her mommy. So we have a little card to say thank you to. So I definitely want to say thank you for everyone. 2020-21, and by the way, if you guys don't know who I am, actually I'm Rebecca, the principal sitting here. 2020 and 21. Thank you for the music, I appreciate it. Very hard year for everyone, not just only for the students, for the parents, for the teachers, right? All the teachers, I know you guys have spent more times put the online material together. And I thank you for the teacher coming to the school every Sunday. Just give all you have and teach our kids, and I just so appreciate it. I thank you for all the parents, online parents, whoever watching, and parents here, for you guys actually support your kids, trusting us, and let them come to learn the Chinese. And I have to say, in this year, nobody gets sick, everybody's safe, we're gonna keep that COVID-19 safe, and also the other things, you guys probably know our CCC Montessori always complain about Chinese school. This is the first year they never ever complain, because we work really hard with them to keep their kids safe too, and we follow all the protocol of what they ask us to do. So all this is because you guys are support, because everyone. So I don't want to cry, but I want to say thank yous. Thank you so much. And also, by the way, I want to say thank you, Tommy, who is our prior principals. He actually has been kind of active a lot of time when I don't know. I actually send him texts or messages asking what do I have to do. And also today, he has an instant job. I asked him to be our MC today. So I say, why is it? So I want to say thank you too. So now, program starts. Thank you, everyone.
Hello, 1, 2, 3, okay, all right, okay, glad to be back. All right, so we're going to have our first part of the program this afternoon is for the graduation. So the first part is, I had to be here.
Yes.
Hi there, everyone.
Hold on 1 second. Can the Zoom, parents, everybody okay? Okay.
Question on the floor?
They will see you from there, yeah.
Okay, all right, so we have our processional first. So I will call the graduate's name, and they're going to proceed to the stage. 毕业生, 胡安怡.
Bye.
毕业生倪爱妮。 毕业生史继山。 毕业生叶鹤山。
从我很小的时候，我就跟着妈妈、姐姐和倪爱妮一起来中文学校学习和跳舞。我很小的时候觉得中文学校是个很大的负担，每次来我觉得是很浪费时间，再加上其他的课外活动，中文课业让我感到是个很大的负担。现在很感谢父母坚持要我学中文，现在也可以跟台湾的爷爷奶奶聊天了。我最爱的课程是烹饪文化课。 可以学到很多美味的中国菜。很感谢老师们这10年教我的中文，也很感谢爸爸妈妈每个礼拜天带我来这边学习中文和跳舞，也感谢倪爱妮这10年在我旁边学习中文。谢谢大家，帮忙帮我毕业了。Hello
everyone, my name is Adrian Hill. Today I graduate, but this is my 10th year at the Chinese School of Delaware. Ever since I was young, I always felt like Chinese school was kind of a waste of time, and I felt like I could be doing something better, for example, like homework or hanging out with friends. But as I grow older, I definitely realized that this is helping me with a possible future career, which I could use Chinese because I'd be bilingual. And this could help me get around so many places in different countries and just get around like places like Chinatown for delicious foods. With that, my favorite class here was the cooking class because I got to learn how to make a bunch of delicious foods. Even though I couldn't eat them, it was good to smell them. I'm really thankful for all these teachers who have dealt with me and my crazy schedules in sports, where I would miss a ton of classes, but they would put the effort in and catch me up with a bunch of classwork that I missed. I'm also very thankful that my mom and dad will bring me here every Sunday and just deal with me complaining about Chinese school when I was young. So I'm super grateful that you guys helped me got through this. And I'm super thankful for my best friend Aileen, who has been by my side for the past decade. And she definitely helped me get through Chinese school, and I don't really know if I'd be here without her. And I'd like to thank you all for providing such a great community where students like me can learn Chinese.
大家好，我是倪爱妮，今天是我最后一天以德利华中文学校学生的身份站在这个毕业台上，我有一种说不出的感伤，因为我舍不得这个学校的人和事，我感觉不久前我还是学前班的学生。 我记得每个星期天都非常兴奋地上中文学校，因为中文课有快乐的歌和文化课的手工艺跟舞蹈。到了七年级，有的时候功课忙不过来，就有了放弃学中文的念头。但是很快，我的理智告诉我这是一个很笨的想法。 学中文有很多好处，如果现在放弃就太可惜了。这所学校在我的生活中有很大的影响。我学了很多中国语言的方方面面，包括演讲的技巧、阅读、写作。 和华人的文化让我对中华文化有了更多的了解。现在我有足够的能力跟华人沟通，如果我去台湾玩的话，肯定没问题的。今天在座的有些同学，现在你们有可能还不能够体会这个学校给我们的帮助。 也许你们觉得学中文很无聊，但是我跟你保证，当你毕业之后所经历的任何事，你一定会感谢在这学校学的一切。所以坚持，不要放弃这个能帮助你以后人生机会的中文课。 最后，我要特别感谢所有帮助我成长的老师们和教职人员，因为他们，所以我才能站在今天毕业的讲台上。我也非常感谢今天坐在我面前的所有人，因为你们和我一起创造了这么多的难忘的回忆。谢谢大家。
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Aileen Ni. It is truly a shock and a whirlwind of feelings to be all standing before you today, possibly for the last time. It felt like just a few weeks ago when I was my happy preschool self. I was always so excited to come to Chinese school because of all the joys, singing, crafts, and dancing. However, when seventh grade came around, Chinese school turned into somewhat of a burden for me. My schedule was constantly packed, and soon thoughts of quitting had emerged. These negative thoughts flitted through my mind before I realized these ideas were foolish. Learning Chinese proved to have many benefits, and to quit now would just be such a shame. This school has played a huge part in my life. It is the reason I am who I am today. I've learned all aspects of the Chinese language, including public speaking skills, reading, writing, and cultural aspects to develop a connection with my cultural ancestry. Now, I can confidently communicate in Chinese, even when I go on vacation to places like Taiwan. Some students here today may not understand the appreciation I feel from the help this school has given to me. Maybe you find it boring to learn Chinese. However, I assure you that when you experience everything after graduation and look back, you will be grateful for everything you learned in this school too. So hold on, don't let go of this opportunity and take all these experiences for granted. Cherish them while you still can. Finally, I would like to thank all the teachers and faculty who helped me grow. It is because of them I can stand before you all today for graduation. I'm so thankful I have created so many precious memories with all the people standing before me today. Thank you all so much.
School of Wilmington 上高中， 我从10岁开始的话中文学校学习中文， 我要谢谢我的妈妈坚持让我学中文， 我也要感谢任老师教我们中文直到毕业。 我还要感谢小张老师和我的同事们，你们给我留下了许多美好的记忆，也是越来越喜欢中文，谢谢大家。 Hello, my name is Samantha. I'm 16 years old and I study at the Charter School of Wilmington. I started Chinese school when I was 4 years old, so I've been here for about 12 years. And I started because my mom wanted me to learn, which I'm very thankful for. I also wanted to thank Ren Laoshi because for the past couple of years, she's been my teacher and she's been very helpful up to my graduation because she has given me a greater appreciation of Chinese. I would also like to thank just the principal and all my other teachers and my classmates for giving me a good time here at the school. I've had very many great memories here that I will always remember, and I'm grateful that you guys made me appreciate Chinese more than originally. Thank you.
Thank you. 17 years old, and I attend Calcala School of the Arts. My hobbies include photography and swimming. I've been at the school, Delaware Chinese School, since I was 7 years old, and it's been 10 years since I'm here. Commencement. I've learned a lot from attending this school. I've had many great experiences. I've gotten a lot of new friends, and the classes have been a lot of fun. Thank you, Ran Lao Shi. Thank you, classmates, and thank you, everyone.
Hello, my name is Hassan Arar. I'm 15 years old and I'm in 10th grade. I go to Brandywine High School and I like to swim and play tennis. I've been coming to Delaware Chinese School since I was 5 years old, and I've been here for about 10 years. And thank you to my parents and the teachers for making this like an enjoyable experience. Thank you, everyone.
Track， 我们做了一个全屏，向你们分享。Or the immersion track, that's us. We made a video that we'd like to share with you guys.
Sorry, we have some technical issues, so we won't be able to play the video. What we figured out, the internet working, and then we'll play again. So thank you for everyone. Again, I say we need our rehearsal, so everything is instant. And we love Instagram, so this everything is instant. Instant play.
What? The first program is presented to you by KA and the first grade. 我爱我的家, I love my family. So please put your hands together and welcome KA in the first grade.
我真有五个人，爸爸妈妈、姐姐、哥哥和我。我喜欢夏天。大家好，我叫魏梦里，我六岁，我家有五个人，爸爸妈妈、哥哥、弟弟和我。
Several awards from ACS, Association of Chinese Schools. The first one is to present the, Li Peiju 老师, Peiju Li, and Chen Qianhui 老师, Cecilia Chen, for the Teacher's Merit Award from ACS. Present the ACS Service Award, Monica Chen, 陈月华老师和资深人员徐正德。
I do want to say thank you to Monica. She's here every Sunday with me, and she has been treasure for our school for 5 years. So thank you for it.
Next, ACS Merit Scholarship recipients, Ni Ai Ni, Xu Ji San. ACS has 6 regions, and we belong to Region 4. So Region 4 has also a merit scholarship. The recipient this year is Hu Anyi.
They forgot the certificate.
Well, she gets it here. She graduated.
Okay, then next one's from WMACS, Washington Metropolitan Area Chinese School Association. From the Peiping Foundation, Peiping Jijinghui. They have a scholarship of excellence. We have three recipients, Ni Ai Ni, Shi Ji San, Hu An Yi.
Yeah, this is really new, the scholarship that they try to encourage everyone who learned the Chinese and then also Chinese culture. I hope they will give us next year too, but this is the first year we received the award for everyone.
ACS, Association of Chinese School, has six regions. Every year, all six regions participate in this association-wide speech contest. There are senior group and junior group. And this year, the first place winner goes to our school. So please congratulate and welcome Ni Ai Ni for the ACS speech contest.
They actually, Eileen also present 2 weeks ago, Memorial Weekend. Usually we have this, actually is in person. This year, online virtual, but she did a presentation to, I know, 100 people in front to demos the what she did. So it's a great job. Thank you.
Eileen did a very, very good job for the speech contest. She has the very good, well, there are several judging criteria. And other than pronunciation content, she has one of the best gesture and the presentation. I know that for the fact because I was one of the judges. Now, there are seven of us, so even though I gave her a whole 100, no, that I wouldn't count. So by knowing she's the first place winner, it just tells you something that not only Ni Ai Ni did an outstanding job in preparing for the speech contest, also the years of practice her skills, and also thanks for the school. I mean, I think Principal Liuwa did a wonderful, wonderful job, and her teacher. Who's her teacher? And I also want to mention one thing, because as a judge, I kind of see a lot of things most people don't see. I think Niani, whoever took the video, I think either it's, it's mom, okay. Very good, the lights, everything was perfect. There are some other contestants. They were very good, but the background was, you know, the light fixture, and they are not so so great. So. Everything included, everything counts. So I sure encourage everyone to practice. And yeah, this is great. Yanni is the fourth first place winner in the history of Chinese school to win this ACS contest. Next one for the ACS Honor Students Society. We have two student places in Honor Society. Hu An Yi, Liao An Zhu. Performed by grades 2 and 4.
A little bit the video is working, so we're going to, sorry, we're going to do this. We'll let our grade the immersion 2i and 4i performance. After that, we'll play the video. Is that work? Okay? Thank you. So bear us, we may change it based on our internet connections. Online parents, bear with us too. Okay. The immersion track 2i and 4i.
Let's go, guys. Okay.
彼此互相帮忙
繁殖其间除了鸟爸爸和鸟妈妈之外，前一年出生的哥哥姐姐也是好帮手，他们会轮流带着昆虫、老鼠、蜥蜴和青蛙回来喂食刚出生的弟弟妹妹。 我们可以看到台湾蓝雀回到巢里把嘴里的食物吐出一些给鸟妈妈，然后和鸟妈妈一起喂食雏鸟，这就是台湾蓝雀特有的习性。台湾蓝雀是台湾特有种鸟类。 有着浅红色的嘴跟爪子，黄色的眼睛，以及比蓝色的羽毛。它特有的华丽尾巴，占全身将近三分之二的长度，尾翼不断的留白，是它在展翅。 飞翔是成为民间美丽的焦点。台湾蓝雀常见于低海拔山区，下次到台湾来，不要忘了找寻它美丽的踪影哦。
That was the video by the immersion track. It was part of our final project, and essentially what we just did is we researched this bird. It's called the Taiwan blue magpie, and it's native to Taiwan. And we just reported on its behaviors, its habitats, what it looks like, and how it raises its young. And we just put it into a presentation and filmed it and put it together for a video. So.
Okay, so now we're going to present the in-class contest awards. The first one present the recitation contest from the fourth grade. So the fourth grade fourth grade recitation contest. First place, Li Mei Mei, Samantha Lin.
She's not here today. I think she went on camping somewhere.
Yeah, she has right.
Second place, Li Na, Lina Abdel Salam. Third place, Wei Zhongnian, Jonah Wilmer. Recitation contest, fifth grade. First place winner, Alexander Edgar. Second place, Emily Kim. Third place, Grant Flink. Citation contest, sixth grade, first place, Ke Zhenda, Jordan Cook. Second place, Shi Jilei, Ryan Smith. Third place, Fan Jie Ke, Jacob Flynn. Speech contest, sixth grade, first place, Ni Ai Tian, Evan Yi. Second place, Lin Zhen Yi, Chloe Lin. Third place, Hu Xiaomiao. Xiaomiao Hu.
He's not here today, he got shots, so he's getting his materials and cannot.
Speech contest, 8th grade. First place, Ni Ai Ni, and Ni. Second place, Hu An Yi, Agent Hu. School-wide speech contest. Junior group, 初级组. 第一名, Ni Ai Tian, Evan Ni. Second place, Lin Zhen Yi, Chloe Lin. Third, Hu Xiaomiao, Xiaomiao Hu.
Yes.
Senior group speech contest, school-wide speech contest. First place, Ni Ai Ni, Ellen Ni. Third place, second place, Hu An Yi, Adrian Hu. For recitation school-wide contest, junior group, first place, Di Ming, Lin Mei Mei, Samantha Lin. Senior group, second place, Yiming, Alex Effinger. Di Sanming, third place, Wei Zhongnian, Jonah Wilmer. School-wide recitation contest, senior group. 第一名, first place, Shi Ji San, Samantha Smith. Second place, Ye He San, Hassan R. 第三名 third place 史继雷 Ryan Smith。Recognition contest, fourth grade, 认字比赛四年级第一名 first place, 林美美 Samantha Lin. Second place, 第二名魏中年 Jonah Wilmer. Third place, the third place.何博言 Nathan Ho. Tag recognition, fifth grade. 第一名, first place, Grant Flynn. Yeah. 第二名, Alexander Avaker, second place. Sixth grade recognition contest. 第一名 first place, 史继雷 Ryan Smith. 第二名柯真达 Jordan Cook. 第三名 the third place, Emily Kim.认字比赛六年级 the CAC recognition 6th grade 第一名 first place 曲文萧 Alison 曲第二名 second place 胡萧苗萧苗胡第三名 the third place, 倪爱天 Evan 倪
She's not here today. She also presented CBS, went to the WMACS to do the competition. And she's probably the youngest one. She did not get like first place, but according to the judge, she did a great job. And she is, what, sixth grade, compete with eighth, ninth, tenth grade. So I just want to recognize her too, that she just did a fantastic job.Thank you for 老师 to work on everybody on word recognition. I know it's hard, especially online. We've never done that before. So thank you for you all. Thank you.
Tech recognition, 8th grade, 八年级认字比赛 First place, 第一名倪爱妮 Alin Lee. second place, 胡安怡 Adrian Wu. now I'm presenting the Academic Achievement Award, 学业总成绩 6th grade, 六年级学业总成绩第一名 first place, 曲文潇 Alison 曲第二名 second place, 胡潇苗潇苗胡Third place, 第三名林真一 Chloe Lin.
Silver, Chloe, you can see it, it's yours online.
八年级学业总成绩 Academic Achievement Awards for the 8th grade. 第一名 the first place, 胡安怡 Adrian Hu.第二名 second place, 你爱你 Alini. For the immersion track, the Academic Achievement Awards, 6th grade, 六年级学业总成绩第一名 the first place, 史继雷 Ryan Smith.Second place, 第二名柯真达 Jordan Cook. Third place, 第三名范杰克 Jacob Flynn. This is special.十年级学业总成绩 for the 10th grade Immersion Track 10th grade Academic Achievement Award. The first place, 史继山 Samantha Smith. Okay, so we have another performance from the Heritage Track and Immersion Track as well.Fifth and sixth graders, 手牵手 hand holding hand. show.